someone can give me some more tunes, we can practice, we can work out when, we can, just any tune, we can work out when is the right foot going. See, that's on Baba, that one.
Anybody else?
Yes, you can. want me to go, upbeat is just like a leading two note.
It's on the second one, no?
An upbeat is the first beat sometimes that leads to the main beat. Yes.
No, it's on the second one.
Yeah. You did it right anyway, you were doing it right.
Where
your hand is really strong, where your strum is really strong, that's where your foot goes. Because you were playing strong on that. Playing the strum really strong, and that's where your foot goes.
So then I also step that tune up here to another rhythm as well.
Yeah, exactly.
So I don't know if that changes that foot.
It does. It changes it depending on the melody. We can go through some anytime.
Yeah.
So let's just carry on. The other thing that Bob talks about is melody and path. So, you know, in kirtan, there may be some people in your group who you find can't sing in tune. You know, melody is a very important part of kirtan, picking the right melody, being able to sing the melody in tune.
Okay.
But you might find in your group there's, you know, people who don't sing in tune. So what's the solution for that? What is the solution for that? I'll just tell you a short story. When I was in Auckland at the Co-op Bakery, we had a bakery many years ago, and there was one sister there. She had the deepest, richest, beautiful voice. It was really rich and gorgeous, but she couldn't sing in tune. She just couldn't sing in tune. And I could be wrong, but I think it may be related to trauma in some past, some childhood experience or something like that. There's some reason why a person can't sing in tune, because naturally, you used to listen to the birds, you listen to nature, there is a melody there. I think, it's just my opinion, but I think that naturally we can all sing in tune. This is my opinion. So when a person can't, I think it's sometimes, rather than feeling upset with that person, we need to feel like a sense of compassion, because there may have been some traumatic experience in their life where they couldn't work through very well, and they had to shut off what's coming into their, what they're listening to. So a person who can't sing in tune is a person who's listening but can't hear. And I'm sure we all have those experiences where someone's talking to us and we can listen, let's say we can hear them, but we're not really listening. We can't listen. It's too much. Maybe it's too overwhelming. There's some blocks there. So one thing that I found with this friend of mine, literally just from singing kirtan every day, 2 or 3 times a day, by the end of two years, she could sing perfectly in tune. So sometimes it's just a matter of patience and just waiting and letting that person just practice the kirtan. And the other method I saw one brother do, who was a teacher of Prabhupada Sangeet, his name is Karit, I think, from Brazil. When he found a person in his class who couldn't sing in tune, he would just go and whisper it in that person's ear. He would actually really whisper very gently, very softly, in the person's ear the melody or that word they were trying to sing. And that seemed to help. Maybe that accelerates the process. But the main thing is to be as gentle as possible with that person, because it is probably some sort of emotional block there. This is just what my experience of that. So melody is very important in kirtan. Melody, choosing a melody that suits the feeling of what you're trying to express. And we need a whole repertoire of kirtans. We need many kirtans to be able to express what we're feeling, because the biggest plus for a kirtan leader is to be expressing what they're feeling at that point in time, because we have feelings for reasons. We have feelings for reasons, and Baba may be giving us that feeling at that time. So to have a kirtan that matches that path or that feeling, that mood, is really nice if you can match the mood, the path, with the kirtan melody that's coming from within you. So to have a repertoire, a nice repertoire of kirtans, is always very helpful, to have many tunes. I know some people who just know 2-3 tunes and they only play those 2-3 tunes because that's all they know. They haven't had the time, and maybe they're just pressed into playing kirtan because there's not enough players. Well, we understand that, but to encourage each other to learn more tunes is also really helpful. Rhythm is very important too. Like in Rari Kirtan, they use a multitude of rhythms. They have different names for those rhythms as well. And in Prabhupada Sangeet, we have Dadra, we have 4 beats, we have 12 beats, we have 5 beats, we have 7 beats. There's different tunes with different rhythms. In kirtan, at the moment we're just doing 4-4. But in Rara, I saw them doing kirtan to 6-8 and other rhythms. They could manage that because they're so experienced at matching the rhythms with the dance. So our kirtan will develop to that point. It will develop. You think Rari Kirtan has been alive for a very, very long time, more than 1,000 years, let's say, and especially since Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which is the 15th century, it's been developing. So they've got 500 years ahead of us, let's say. So they're really well developed. But we're just developing, and we're developing in Nanda Marga as we go. And so to develop, first of all, getting the step right with the music is very important. And then in future, you'll see our kirtan will develop. They have all these beautiful dance movements that they do that doesn't make them go out of beat. They're still in beat, but they're doing twirls, they're doing steps forward and steps back, because they have the rhythm under control. So rhythm is important, not for the dance only, but just for the music. If we're going along and we're singing in the same rhythm, it's not as dynamic as it could be. So by, you know, feeling, when you feel within yourself the intensity of emotion arising, then express that through your kirtan, express it through the rhythm, through your melodies, express that. You can accelerate it, you can decelerate it as well. And it's not an artificial acceleration, it's coming from within. It comes from your own emotion. Yeah. And they do that, they utilize that a lot in the Rari Kirtan.
May I say something?
Yes, please.
I just heard somebody saying that when we all do kirtans together, and maybe we go to some sad melodies and then some very low melodies, and then maybe in the morning there comes this feeling of, wow, now it's rising, the was like happy kirtans, and somebody said like we are all going through the same kind of mood, and it's becoming a collective body,
mm-hmm.
and everybody is sharing this emotion, and this brings up as if we are surpassing something very deep together.
Mm-hmm.
Like everybody had some sadness in their life, and we all having the same tune and maybe different reasons is behind, but we as a whole body, we are moving through this, and by this we get into a higher psychic
mm-hmm.
level. And sometimes after a night, you're going through the night together, you feel like there's a new dawn in the morning, and you feel so happy as if you have overcome something very deep. And
yeah, true. Does anyone else have experience with that? Do you want to share something?
No, I don't want to share, but I feel the total atmosphere. And it sometimes it can be changed. Like you can be sad, and then you come and swim kirtan, and you start to be happy. You don't understand why you were sad.
Yes.
And sometimes vice versa. You are happy, and then you just listen to this sad music, and you just like. You're not trying to remember your past situation,
no.
Said, but it's like
happening
yeah.
Inside. Exactly. You can experience the same just from, no? In
yeah.
You can really feel that the minds and the hearts are moving together.
Mm.
That's what it's like with it. I find that's the most moving aspect.
Mm.
You're so close to Baba then, because you really feel like, you know, we're all one.
Mm.
It's really beautiful.
Mm.
Like sharing exactly the same, the roller coaster of emotions. And, yeah.
Sometimes I remember when I was in India one time and we were singing Kirtan Baba, and we were singing, it was in Lake Gardens, and it was so strong. And that Baba, when Baba came back, he could not but come into the room. He came into the room and he sat and he listened, and everybody was just singing with total devotion. And he had to come in. He had to come. And this is what happens when we sing kirtan. He has to come. If we're really feeling that devotion, he has to come. He came and he sat and he listened and he smiled and he closed his eyes. And then he left. And then he went up into his bed, up into his room. He didn't leave, he went up into his room. So, you know, when we sing that kind of bhav, we get the results.
Can you tell something about the valves? The different. Is it possible that we also have different valves when we're doing this whole night kirtan?
I think the personal relationship we have with Baba is very personal. It's very, you know, individual. Very individual. How we express into Baba
mm-hmm.
at the time. It's very personal, and that's the thing about kirtan, is that we can get. In our relationship with Guru, there's no censorship. We can express whatever we feel in our kirtan. And that's what I learned. I had a kirtan teacher in Ra for many years, and he said to me, they would use the mantra Hari Bolo. So his key thing he said to me is that we are using only two words, Hari Bolo, but through these two words we express all of our emotion. And you can see that in the kirtan, because sometimes it's very, very sensual and very beautiful and graceful, and other times it's fierce as, and they're just looking like they can murder somebody. Not really murder, but they're just giving it whack, yeah, he's going for it. And it's like this collective energy of being able to express anger, all kinds of emotion, but not really, I don't know how to say sentient anger, how to say that exactly, but it's all the emotion coming out through the kirtan, through playing of the drums, through the singing, through the dance.
Mm-hmm.
And that's one of the attributes of Rari kirtan. It can be very tender, but very fierce at the same time. Different parts of the song, different parts of the rags. And some are very joyful, like Daspera is a common rag. It's very joyful and uplifting. And then there's Jor Chuta, which is very romantic, or Payamita, but it's very romantic. And they're doing like a very graceful movement. And then there's the Paka Chuta, is another rag that they do, which is very serious rag. A very serious rag. This particular rag Rari Kirtan is in 3.5. 3.5, that's what they say. But then you come back to the stepping on the right foot.
What do you mean it's stuck?
Yeah, like,
it's a different
time. Yeah, I like the control when she comes back. She's playing 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and it's not a 4-4, it's a 3-and.
Oh, wow.
And so the feet don't go all the time on the right foot, but it comes back to the right foot.
Oh, wow.
So that's one of the rites that we play. And it has a very romantic mood, and so those kind of emotions can be expressed. And then there's others that are more fierce and has more fierce emotion. So, yeah. So Baba talks about, so we that was a little bit about the science. The ascetics. What is the ascetics? The ascetics is a subtle sense of pleasure. A subtle sense of pleasure and also a style. So we have classical music styles, folk music, jazz, hip hop, etc. And we have, when you hear that music genre, you know it's that because you can hear from the sound of the drums or the voices, you know exactly when it's rap, you know it's rap. You hear classical music, you know it's classical music. Same with kirtan. It's the same with kirtan. Mm-hmm. So when you come up to the Hare Krishna, you hear the sound of the kol and the mridangam and the kartal and the singing, you know it's kirtan. So similarly, with our own kirtan, how would you feel about if we would have, you know, for example, punk music playing an orchestral piece? How would you actually call that as a genre? Would you call it punk or would you call it orchestral music?
Maybe we don't know what you mean.
Yeah, or maybe, what if you heard someone playing with a jazz band playing Bhavanam Kevalam? What would you think? Would you call that kirtan?
Mm-hmm. Actually, Jabba said that we should not sing kirtan in the tune or like other music because it has already a particular idea. I mean,
yeah,
it feels strange. Mm-hmm. It feels as something doesn't fit,
like club song or rock song, or, because it has already its own idea. I mean,
I know one lady, she was often playing in the kind of music she was used from before. She was really, and she loved that kind of music, and people loved that kirtan also.
Mm-hmm.
It can be that you use some
no, but Baba said
or
that.
But then still, I think that's just not telling we should know more different kirtans to play and so. I think you feel attracted to some kind of something. It can be that you have some.
But in my opinion, like those who make kirtan tunes, you know, it comes, that inspiration comes from Baba itself. Then just get that inspiration. Because then that inspiration is coming from him. That is that it has more effect, mental effect, because the bhava is paramapurusha. It's coming. That inspiration is there. In case I sing like, let's say a rock tune in a kirtan, no? People know that tune, so.
But
and there we can find something in the memories. Like they did something when this student was they were smoking or they drinking.
Yes. It creates a different, you know,
mood.
I remember when I was at LFT training years ago in Sydney, and there was this one tune that they used to always play, and every time they played it, I just couldn't stop myself laughing. You know the song, freight train, going so fast. Does anyone know that? Meter would know that one. Freight train, anyway, it's a children's song. So every time they would play that in Barman and Cameron, I just couldn't contain myself. I would just laugh, you know, because it was like a bit of a mismatch, is what I'm saying. It's a bit of a mismatch, but yeah, he's right. The ideation is important, and you're also right that sometimes you find a tune that actually does really bring out some emotion. You know, that does really connect emotionally. That's also true, I think. So when we feel that path, we'll find a tune that goes with it. I just wanted to say that in terms of what they say in Ra is that you can add anything to the kirtan, but kirtan never changes. That's what they say. So what they mean by that is that the kirtan tals that they've developed, the kirtan ragas that they've developed, it's like a Beethoven or a Bach piece. It never changes. It always exists. It's there forever. And that's part of the genre. Just like kirtan has in Ra, it has its own pieces, its own compositions, its own composers, and just like any other genre. And we don't have that yet in the West. We have a few that are very well known, like there's some from George Harrison, for example. There are some that are very well known, some other kirtans probably. But in Ra, there's like a whole body of work that they learn over years and years and years. So that genre is very developed. And we can develop it too. We can develop our own kirtans as well. We can do that with our Prabhat Sangeet, with our own melodies. We can develop them, and they can be part of a huge collection of kirtans that are part of our tradition, of our spiritual path. Mm-hmm. And they are, you know, you could say fixed, and they have, they'll be there like for generations, let's say. We can do that as well. It's part of it growing. Now it's alive. Kirtan is an alive tradition. It's growing, it's growing. So you need not be afraid of it.
Yeah.
And just want
so
to,
when you were doing this, because Joshua explained me once, and you hear this da da da, because it's a children's song in where you come from. That's why she felt like always laughing, because it was not kirtan, it was a children's song. That's how you learned it. No? Yeah.
So this is, you can't see this very well, but this demonstrates what how developed Rari Kirtan is. It's got these different parts to it. And I discovered that, I unraveled that through my own work of listening and recording and then asking questions, what's this, what's that? And I tore back their service and found the structure inside of the kirtan that they've been using for centuries. And they, like an orchestral piece, they have a structure. And that structure is there inside of their kirtans, and that's what keeps it very strong, very, very strong. We at the moment we have developed, we have our Lalita Mamaka. We don't yet have choreography, but that will develop. Here they have what's called the first part of the melody, which is called Daspera La, for example, the La part, which is like a melodic phrase which they develop and they repeat and they repeat. And then they bring in some improvisations called low, middle, and high voice. They bring in some improvisations, and this is over a period of, say, 20 minutes, 30 minutes. One kirtan song, one kirtan of theirs. They bring in improvisation, and they go back to the main melody, and then they'll do what's called, they'll bring in a second melody, and that second melody might be the, for example, it might be a verse of a song, the melody from a verse of a song. And with that, they do a beautiful choral composition. So they have these beautiful compositions worked out already on the cauldron. They bring in the cauldron, they'll do like a solo, not a solo, because the mantra's going on continuously. They'll bring that in. And then at the end, they do this mighty climax, this huge, massive climax where they're really going fast and faster and faster. So in the beginning, it's really, really fast. Before here, actually, there's this huge climactic beginning. Then they bring in the main melody, they're coming back in slow, they're building it up, they build it up more with these improvisations. Then they have, there's a matan here. They have the first climax for the first part of the tune. Then they bring in the cold drums. Then they bring in, then there's a different rhythm comes in. And then they have like the mighty climax at the end of this one particular piece. And that's one ra, ketan ra. This is how they structured theirs. At the moment, what we have Lalita Mamapa. We don't have any other choreography. We don't have any drum language. We don't have any particular drum rhythms that are set for ketan as yet. We don't have any yet. And we don't have a structure yet. We don't have that. We don't also have cymbal parts, which they have.
Harmonium.
In place of harmonium, we have guitar usually. They play harmonium, we have guitar. My ketan teacher said guitar is fine. You know, there's no problem with that. Guitar is like a harmonium. It actually aids the singer to keep their tune on, to keep the melody going. With pitch, it helps with pitch. So it's good. So, you know, we can look at this and go, oh my God, you know, I've got so far to go. Or we can look at this and go, wow, we've got so much that we can do. We can develop this ourselves. We can develop it through time, you know, and through practice. So we don't have much more time. I think we probably run out of time. But I just wanted to...
What time did you stop doing?
So just the super part of it. Yeah, already 11 minutes over.
Can you move on to the next one?
So just, that's a little touch on the aesthetics of it. It's developed as, ketan has a style, and it's also to do with arrangements. We can make beautiful arrangements with our vocal parts, with our harmonies, with our other instruments. We can combine the Western style of gospel, for example, with the Eastern style. We can do all kinds of things with our ketan. And in this way develop it. And then lastly, the ideation or the supra, the transformational part of the ketan. It's like, that's where Baba says, the supra part of it comes with having used the science. It's like when you have a scientific experiment, if you do it again and again, it'll have the same results. So if you have a structure, if you have the melodies, you have the rhythms, you have all the dance working together, you have all those components, then you will have this transformational experience. It's like, it's guaranteed. Baba talks about having a method. If you have a method, you have 90% success rate. So we may go into ketans and not really experience the high that we're really longing for, and I feel that's because there's many components that we're not actually utilizing. There's many aspects of ketan that we haven't yet developed. And we need to. You know, we can do that together. We really can. So
I think, like in education, Baba did not give a specific system. Because he doesn't want us to get, trapped in one system like Steiner, Montessori, you know. He wants us to, we should expand. Yeah.
Yes.
So it should be free.
Yes.
But Baba gave very specific thing about kirtan is the ideation.
Mm-hmm.
The ideation is very important.
Baba did speak about the science of kirtan. He says there is a real science behind kirtan, and he says one sentence and you could take like 10 PhDs on rather than what is that science, because it is so deep and there is a lot to learn. We can learn from people like this who have been doing it for like more than 500 years. You know, we can really learn. Because that experience, I've never experienced it so strongly as I did in Rari Ketan. I never had that same experience except there.
That power you can also experience even you're alone.
Yes.
This is the power, this is the mantra of Baba is so powerful.
Yeah.
And you can feel the power even you're alone.
That's right.
I
no, you're right, you totally should be. But I'm just saying, as a collective,
yeah,
as a genre of collective ketan, maybe there's something we can learn from this.
Mm-hmm.
And I just really love this quote here. Baba talks about emotions are essential for devotion. Baba says, I transfer my nucleus to the place, this is what Dedi's saying, really. I transfer my nucleus to the place where my devotees sing my name. Why? Because in devotees there is an upsurge Ujjvalasa, Ujjvasa, Ujjavasa, and emotion, Aveda. With the help of that emotion, I radiate vibrations in the universe. So basically it comes down to emotion and devotion. So if there's any way, if I can help anyone with anything, with their kirtan, just please, just ask me. I'm happy to help in any way. We've got a kirtan course, a beginner's course coming up in the Kirtan Academy in September. If anybody is interested, just let me know. And we've got a kirtan mela coming up in September too, our first kirtan mela festival at the Master Unit in Ireland at the end of September. Everyone's welcome. And that's an interfaith ketone, so people from different groups will be doing their ketone and we'll be doing it together in separate. Yeah, any questions, please? I know we've run out of time, but if you have anything you want to say, please just ask.
What you meant when you said interfaith, it's like it's online or interfaith or different religions?
Different spiritual groups, yeah.
Oh, how do you do this with ketone?
They sing their mantras and then we just have like relays, like we do 2 hours, they do 2 hours, so we fill up
like
the whole
Shiva
place.
Mantra or Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm. Anita?
Did the sister who you helped sing in tune?
Yeah.
Did you talk with her over? She sang out of tune?
No, actually, because in those days, this was like in the 80s, like I didn't really even think about it. It was just the process of we're just doing kirtan together, but I noticed it, you know.
Okay.
I could hear the difference from the beginning to
when I was in Jiva sector, no, we had kirtan, very many kirtaniyas there. Right? We could, like this thing that you were saying that it goes, the vibration builds up. We had that many times when I was working in Jiva sector.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we have many, many good. The thing is that what I have noticed is, like in Berlin sector, they go more for the beat,
yeah.
You know? But it should be more for the ideation, you know? For the feeling, that love, that feeling of love,
mm-hmm.
You're singing it for Baba. It's not more for the beat, because then it becomes very external. So there
but
should
the
be more,
for
there
the
should
feeling.
Be more, there should be more this devotional flow there. It's not only the dancing, but the that everybody's mind is focused on Baba.
Yeah.
You know, then it gives a different kind of flow. Very different. But you can see that this Ravi, because all of them are concentrated in one. Even I am not there, I know what they're doing. They are concentrated there. That's why they get that force. So that is what is lacking. It needs to be developed. That this more ideation. There should be more ideation on Baba. Then the kirtan becomes very sweet.